What's up, everybody? I know it's been a little bit, but I'm Phil with the Phil Talk Sports Podcast with episode 3.
Hello.
My Darren Sproles One Last Ride Superstar Mode. I'm going to try this week. All right, we're going right into it. It's more frequently now. We're undefeated. No, we have one loss. And I simmed it on accident. Hope everybody had a good Halloween. If you went out and did anything.
Now we're talking. It's the coach.
All right, coach.
On EA Sports. Coming up, running back Dalvin Cook. He's back and coming out of a big game a weekend ago. That'd be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Minnesota Vikings. With that, we send you up to US Bank Stadium in.
All right, here we go.
To the 29 and a gain of 4. So we'll look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next
is that
man,
better?
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well.
I bought a second controller from a flea market over the weekend. That seems to work fine. It was $10. But I guess I found the one issue with it is the microphone jack. So that's fine. I'll just use my other one when I stream. No big deal. All right. Third down and 2. Sorry about all that. Just start the thing. Here we go. Third and 2. Let's see if we can pick it up. Ooh, I think they should give us that. Yeah, first down.
They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up.
The Eagles picked up a big win against the Bills, trying to keep that going against the Bears. There we go, out of the backfield. This week, and I mean, the Bears are not looking the best, so I like our chances.
A gain of 15.
And an Eagle first down. Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield.
Is nobody going to come? Nobody's going to come? I'll take that. Good stuff.
Let's go.
Nobody carried over.
Executed 22-yard gain.
Let's look at the replay.
That's an excellent read right there.
Yeah, well, I'm the only one on that side of the field.
That means it's just
not like they didn't have time to figure it out.
So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, Kelp is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
Over the middle. Sean Jackson with the first down.
Let's go. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. Wentz going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Wentz now to throw. Completes it to Aguilar.
All right. 9 yards to Aguilar. Let's see what we can do here.
How about this first drive? They're being aggressive, slinging it around.
First down, touchdown. There we go.
Darren Sproles. So on 4th down,
and that will punt return as they are pretty deep, the 33. They did not get far on there. They drive
four
here.
Times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. This will be taken
at the 10. Return. Nothing big there.
We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Let's go.
Okay, so here is our rush yards on the season already.
And we checked the rushing numbers so far here.
Right around the 500 yard mark with 9 touchdowns, which our goal was only 5. I did not know how much play time he was going to get. So it's a pretty loaded backfield. And 9 rushing touchdowns, that doesn't even account for the receiving yards, receiving touchdowns. Yeah, looking at a Pro Bowl year if we can keep this up going. Let's move. Third and 5. Oh, that was not a good read on my part. Okay, let's see what happens here. And we stop.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Sproles.
I have not figured out how to be very effective as a returner yet. Kick returns make it a little easier, but yeah, I don't get very far on punts, it seems.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And on the last score, they couldn't get anything going.
They had to come from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position.
17 yards on the ground, but I do have that touchdown. And that's the end of the first. So I learned the hard way. Don't use my $10 controller when I have a headset in. But now we know. And knowing is half the battle. I forgot it was third. That was not even worth it. Alright, let's see if we can see what's going on more so here. 3 yards by Dalvin. 2 more. 12 to Stephon Diggs. Back 2 yards. Kyle Rudolph, 9. And penalty against the defense. 5 more. The Vikings. I was just about to say, have a drive going, and as it continues, Cousins complete. 2 yards. 3rd and 8, and they only get 7. So 4th and 1, the Vikings get a field goal. All right. I'm still out wide. This is crazy. Alright, I'm just gonna run my route this time.
I'm gonna
let me move there for a minute. Okay, so we lost yard. Let's try to sneak up the middle here. Nope. If I'd have gone past that first level, I felt like there was Not a bad time to break one of those out. Let's see.
Coachman in the game at Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Screen pass to Sproles.
Not a good call.
The Vikings get a signal for the first of their timeouts. So as they take
it. So we're going to punt. See how their 2-minute drill is here. Diggs. 8-yard penalty against the defense. Diggs again. Pass knocked away. Oh, big play that I missed, but then a sack. And then an incompletion. 3rd and 13. Diggs gets 11 and a 50-yard field goal. and that puts us up only one. See what we can do with a minute and two timeouts.
On first down, Lance. This one complete to Sproles. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia.
Okay, I might have to be the one calling the timeouts here.
11 passing in this first half.
And going deep. Oh. Out of reach for who I think was Zacherts. He's trying to score and strike, so I'm just going to go straight up and hopefully he throws to the sideline. And caught and to the sideline. That's exactly what we wanted. Aguilar with the catch and got out of bounds. Keep it moving. If we could even get a field goal out of here, I'd call that a win.
Going on first is Wentz.
Get a bounce. Yes, okay.
It's complete. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play.
I feel like I had a chance to either get the first down or get out of bounds, and that's a little more important right now. I'm going to try this draw, and hopefully that at least gets us in better field range, and that gets us going.
He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
I got like a yard or two.
The second of their timeouts.
Right, let's try this corner strike.
With 12 seconds to go in this first half.
And I'm again just going to go up.
Wentz going to try and throw on third.
And a catch and an out of bounds.
An Eagle first down, Wentz to Ertz.
Here we go, here we go.
Okay, we're down to the 24. 8 seconds. I'm going to run it up the middle and then call one more timeout.
12 of 15 throwing the ball, 80% so far, and it's first and 10. They'll run it with Sproles.
There we go. And a timeout. Good gain of should be an easy down. Field goal.
Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half.
And field goal. So we have 10-6 at half. Vikings get the ball first. Jenkins is injured. That's not good. 3rd and 7. And they complete. They've been bad on third down. They've been like a yard or two shy of all their first downs. On third, anyway. Alright, big drive for them. 3rd and 6. See? To 5. And a field goal. So we're again up by 1. So, I mean, they have a good defense. I knew I wasn't going to, like, probably have huge yards in the run game. The goal looks like is to, get 50. And I'm about halfway there. Ouch, yeah. Harrison Smith is that dude, man. He is tough. Alright, so, I mean, I'm making plays in the pass game. I've already got a touchdown. Let's at least pick up that blitz, which gets the first down. I need to at least get my 50 yards. That could be the goal for this game. I'm at 27 right now on 10 carries, which I'm bad at math, but that is not a good average. As I break one tackle, and I squeeze forward for about 7, 6, 7. Could have easily been stopped in the backfield there. Alright, I'm gonna try the outside. I haven't really gotten outside yet. Ooh, I might be onto something. Okay. I'm gonna try some more outside runs, because that might be the ticket here.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Gonna make that defense stand up and stop them.
Oh, look at that! Running room.
Uh
oh.
And
55. There's the goal right there. And I also break 500 yards rushing in the season. We might have figured out. It might have taken me like 2.5 quarters, but and I have 114 total yards on the day. But yeah, I think I figured it out. Outside run.
Pretty good results here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about 6. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
I'm always hesitant for... Oh, where am I? Okay, what's my route? I'm out. Okay. Hesitant on curls when it's the computer throwing. They throw a lot of picks, but he went inside with that one. First down. Let's try this jet sweep. I'd like to try one of them a game. Just to keep them on their toes. Okay, here we go. And Mac to the outside. Okay. 9 yards. And he gets hurt.
Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an eagle slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside.
Read option. Let's give that a go. Gotta throw a little bit of everything at him. Okay, and now I got it up the middle. Down to the one, two. Down to the two.
15 yards on the play, first down.
Let's go, boys, let's go!
And that is the end of the third quarter. This is about what you expect from a defense as good as them. I'm going to try the jet sweep one more time. I don't know if he's running it. All right, it's Jackson. I like those odds. But we're going to run to the other side. Yeah. What's funny is if Jackson had the one that Mac had, he probably has the speed to break that away. Okay, let's try a play action rollout. Plenty of guys on the right side, and I'm just going to stay in the block. And touchdown, Ertz. Here we go. Play call. They were kind of stacking the box. I figured somebody would be out there. And now we are up 8. Oh. Okay, we have the ball. What did I miss? Did I just zip through it all that quickly? Okay. Outside running. We gotta keep that going. Okay. It won't show me, but we have the ball at the 24, so I assume there was some sort of turnover. Outside. My younger Jason Peters seals that block, and I am gone. Alright, we can put it away right here. This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense. I think he got his hands on it, but it was knocked away. We had pressure over here that I eventually got to, but he had already thrown the ball at that point. All right, who is this? Looks like Aguilar. Yeah, he had his hands on it, but Telvin Smith is... He looks like he wanted to, like... If somebody was over there, he wanted to, like, tap it to him. And we almost get intercepted there by the linebacker, whose name I can't read because of his hair. No big deal. But, okay, so the pass was on the money. But it was a pretty small window. Let's try this RPO. I don't know how to do these RPOs very well, like when I control the quarterback, but the CPU does them fairly well. As I say that as he Tebow's one and throws it in the dirt. But I will say he made the right read, it looked like. I mean, alright, I'm not going to bother. But, I mean, he was open, it appeared. Alright, field goal time. Oh, did we go? We must have gone for it on fourth with me not on the field. Alright, we're gonna run the same play that we ran for the first touchdown. I don't think they're ready. And same play, same guy, same touchdown. Deja vu all over again. Let's go. And same, okay, different celebration, but yeah, they were not ready for that in the red zone, it would appear. And Jake Elliott misses the extra point. That shouldn't be a huge deal, but okay. 14-point lead now, with just under four to go. Is there a way to watch? Cancel sim? Is that a thing? I think you can only watch if you're, like, GMing and simming or the coach or whatnot. Alright, let's see. I remember getting to watch field goals at one point. Stephon Diggs, 24 yards down to the 10. Down to the 4. And a touchdown. So we are up by a touchdown now. And this extra point way more prominent now. Alright, let's continue the game plan of outside runs. stay in inbounds. Those are the two names of the game. Let's try some more play action, a different one. Because we've been running the ball effectively enough that we should play on some stuff. We got Carson. Okay, I'll take it. It should be first or close. First down, okay. And that's 2 minute warning. So one more first down would just about do this. My outside run. I'll do a counter.
So it's Eagle football here as we get to reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this
here
one.
Here we go. Give me a seam and an alley. And a first down. Alright, then we'll look at they have timeouts, but that otherwise would have done it. Alright, so that should put me over 100, I would think. Alright, I will go up the middle now. 110 rushing yards. Right, I think not all of those are me, but pretty close. Screen to Jackson. That gets 1 yard or none. But it does cost the timeout. Okay, 2 yards. Okay, let's do this stretch. So one more, as I know I already said this, but one more first down should do the trick just because they won't have any timeouts. Nope. Okay. At least we're out of timeouts now. It is 3rd and 7.
Okay.
They want me to run. I was thinking of play action. Do I bother? I mean, yeah. Cut inside, though. Yeah. Whoa. Ooh. That was the last guy that I wanted to hit me to, but at least I stayed in bounds. All right, so my first 10 carries, I only had 27 yards. My second 10 carries, have really been important, but yeah, that was a stretch play that I cut inside. I think they were finally getting the hang of, all right, let's meet him to the corner, and that might have been the difference, but look at Harrison Smith come in here, and that could have been a fumble. That looked like the fumble animation. Luckily, I stayed in bounds and everything. All right, so with 122 remaining, we're just going to waste a lot of this clock. Draw. The outside. Make a move. And
he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. 8 yards on the pickup. And now
I'm going to run this play action. I'm just going to wait a while. I assume he'll throw it. Got it.
Second down. And they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing.
Right there, 54,
right
there, right there. All right, here we go.
And there
we go, that was beautiful. Just what I was expecting. I picked up that blitz perfectly, and then it was more of a tunnel screen, and he got to the corner. That was perfect.
Do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to...
I doubt it's going to... Yeah, it's not going to let me. But I've gotten pretty good at picking up the blitz, and I was pretty happy about that. All right, now we're up 14 again. 30 seconds to go. And that should just about do it. They're running the ball. I guess they didn't really feel the need. All right, 9 seconds. I have to run the ball. I could kneel it, but I don't like to make it, so here we go. Got a few more yards.
I know you feel that.
All right, that's another win. Win number 5 out of 6. It was close there for a while. They were playing catch up for a lot of it. We figured out running the outside, which then opened up the play action, which which was all three touchdowns were off of play action. So it took me a minute, but I figured out what they were doing. Does it let me watch the touchdown? Yes, it does. Okay. I just wanted to give a shout out to myself the way I'm able to pick up these blitzes, because he came off the edge. He was ready to go, and this would have easily been a sack, but because I was able to get that,
so for our entire crew,
Goddard is, that's the fullback. The fullback clears. Goddard's right behind him. And then the fullback makes a block, kind of. He at least gets in the way, and then nobody can get the angle. So that was the difference maker at that point. And the Eagles don't have a fullback on the roster, so this is just some dude that they, you know, signed in the game. But great job. The fullback is not dead, which is great news. Alright, I think I have time for one more game here. I always try to do two in these episodes. Okay, let's see if we got any advances. And a big week 7 matchup against the Dallas Cowboys, which, a game we did not win in real life. We did not come close to winning in real life, but it did seem to be a wake-up call, which, hey, you need that sometimes. Alright, here we go against Dallas, and then I'll do another episode, and I'll knock out, basically, it'll be after we played the Bears, but I'll knock both those games out in the next episode, and then we'll basically be caught up with the season. Sneakers hurt my feet now. Every beat is getting beat down. Couldn't eat, well, watch I eat now. Like, how you getting paid to freestyle? Different cities every week now. Every woman is now. What state brought you looking bleak now? Here we go.
Hey, everybody, it's the coach. You're tuned in to Sunday Night Football on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles as they take on Dak Prescott and the defending NFC East champs, the Dallas Cowboys. I'll join you again at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from earlier this afternoon. But for now, it's Sunday Night Football.
And here we go.
As always, Brandon Godden.
Eagles Cowboys in Jerry World. And the Cowboys go right down the field and kick a field goal. Alright, so I'm going to start inside here, and then maybe we'll have to make the same adjustment. Okay. So I had like 120 yards on 12 carries in the second half against the Vikings. If my quick math is correct. We're gonna go for it early here. We're gonna give him a shot. Ooh, Carson! I blocked one, but there was two. Sean Lee, man, I might hate the Cowboys, but I've always liked Sean Lee from college and everything else. It's a shame how, like, injury-prone he's been. I'd like to see him. You know, they're probably going to move off him here due to, you know, that Vanden Bosch guy. Or Vander Esch, right? Vander Esch, the other linebacker. So, like, I'd like to see him get a shot somewhere else. And while I'm sitting here babbling, we go 3-and-out, which is not good. All right, let's see the Cowboys. Deja vu, another field goal. All right, so the goal, I just saw it. I'm supposed to try and get my 10th rushing touchdown of the year today. So, and the pass is wide. Okay, so Alshon Jeffrey's been out, Malik Jackson's out, Maddox comes back next week.
They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
All right, so that will definitely help the passing game, getting him back. Because we basically have three receivers that do the same thing. We have three speed receivers. First down, three speed receivers, no possession receiver. Which is, of course, Alshon Jeffrey's one of the better possession vertical receivers in the game. All right, let's try to go outside. Let's see if he actually hands it off. Nope. Is that going to be, like, rough in the pass? See, that's the thing about these RPOs. Unless you throw them immediately, like, the time it took them to fake the handoff, you know, illegal downfield. Okay, which I kind of got glitched in there, but now it's a third and one. Holy cow, end of the first already. All right, so we got to get going here.
Both times that they met, with Philly coming off their Super Bowl title, but in weeks 10 and 14, it was Dallas beating Philly by a single possession. Well, he's not going to get there.
It's third and one, and now we have to punt. And the Cowboys with a touchdown. All right, we gotta pick it up here. This is starting to look like the real life game. I mean, no turnovers or like stupid mistakes necessarily, but just ineffectiveness. Get a feel. All right.
And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Play action.
A good spot to take a shot. Here, yeah. Second and a yard from the 34.
The 34-yard line.
Here's Winston. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Right, play action might not be the move here. They have too many guys up front. And if they got to be play actions, they got to be quick.
Such an impressive first half to get that lead.
Right up the middle, caught right by the star. A little ad lib. The guy gets his deep downfield.
Let's go!
Goes for 29 yards on third down.
I'll try up. Oh, two
minutes. Here's another first and 10. 2 minutes remaining in this first half for football.
Let's see if they'll leave me alone the way Minnesota did on this.
Nope.
Well, I am taking the star linebacker off.
This complete left side to Aguilar. And he gets it inside the 35 and just.
All right, first down.
It's an Eagles first down and a gain of 11.
All of our all of our draws get the high snap animation. Oh, is he gonna stay? Oh, beautiful. Oh, Carson, come on! You're not gonna get that many times.
As they'll stop him with just over a minute to go before halftime.
That was, could have been a touchdown, easily a huge first down. He didn't see it, and I don't know why. Can I replay? Because it was the, nope, because I'm in this. All right.
From the gun, it's Wins.
Let's make up for it now. Here we go, down to the six.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
You don't want to give them a lot of time here, right? If this draw gives a high snap animation again, I'm over. Ah, see? Every time. And it slows down the delivery, and yeah. Because whether it's run or pass, when they see that high snap, they're coming. So, yeah, no more draws, I guess, for a while. Oh, and he dropped it. Third down. All right, I'm gonna try my double pivot. I don't have to beat anybody deep, but I should pull the linebacker or the corner out. Okay.
Let's
see what we are deciding. Because I don't get to make that call. Alright, we're kicking the field goal. Down 10. Okay. I can't help but think we should. should have been in the end zone. We did not handle that possession. Should have. Oh! I didn't even call for that. That probably would have put the game in playoffs. The way we're playing right now. Alright, here we go. Second down. Oh! Look at that! Huge play. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they made. And that just means one big score. Already in the second half. Let's try up the middle. No draw. That's been an issue for them in this game. Now a handoff here to his running back. Oh, okay. More than I thought, but still not a lot. I call that play a success. Trying outside. Sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play. Again, they'll run it. Again, it's Sproles. Follow the blocks. One move. There we go.
Works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 12 yards there and a first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this a little bit of math here.
I don't want to. This should be a fairly quick play.
That's pretty good recipe for success.
Let's see what we got. Carson, just hit me. Oh.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive. Knowing each other's
moves. Now it's Hurts for what should be the first down.
They've been on the spot. Just
first and two.
They've held them in check on the scoreboard.
All right, this drive is
critical. About at halftime, whatever it was, it worked.
All right, let's see.
Like
this is the guy that just stood there last time.
Very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
To throw his wins. The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith.
I feel like I'm going to be looking for that the whole game, and our one chance to do that is probably over. All right, second and 10.
Again, it's Wentz. This will be caught just inside the 10.
Is that first? Third and two. All right, let's go for the slants. Stay in the block here. And look for that 10th touchdown. No, we got to go for it. The field goal doesn't really help us here. Trying to go no huddle. Is he going to let me? Alright. Field goal. And alright, now we're down 14. And okay, this might not be our day, guys. Oh! We are getting killed. This is just like the real life game. Nice. Fourth quarter. Let's see. Let's just go wide open. I'm like the only guy getting open, it seems. That's probably just because I'm going rogue on the routes.
How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of the defense.
Caught by Zachary. No! And now he's hurt. That's the last thing we needed. Now we'll go for it. We'll go for it on our own 26, but we wouldn't go for it on 4. 4th in the game, it would appear, and that's not even close. This is the kind of game that in real life, you know, fans want the coach fired, they want the janitor fired, they want the play-by-play guy fired. It's one of those games, and you're down, you're bound to have one, at least one of those a year.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete.
This is the roughest game we've ended. The first true loss of the series. With, ran a draw, not even thinking about it, but hey, free 15. Their opportunities were missed in this. Like, clearly our defense, isn't doing well against them, but, like, offensively, we've just missed some things. We could easily be down like 7 right now instead of 21. Oh! Catch by Mac on the tip, just like you drew it up. I keep calling draws, but I know I shouldn't call draws. It's just a play action. Go Goddard. And down to the 19-yard line. We're playing for pride at this point, so we gotta get a touchdown. If the game's out of reach, hopefully it can be. So let's see. Open field with a full head of steam. Oh, that would have been great. I should have went outside.
The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there. The Eagles on third down, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. This is 3rd and 9. That is caught inside the 5.
And all right, down to the 3. Goddard with the catch. Let's try and get my touchdown. Let's get something positive out of this. Get the boost for it. And down to the 1.
And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
Yeah, baby.
They got 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal.
Let's get one more. Oh, 2 minutes.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got it 2nd and goal as they look for a touchdown.
Oh, in the backfield. Not good.
He's going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what happened to Weak Mix last week. He ran pretty much wild. He didn't do pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold.
And this is
caught by DeSean Jackson. Stops it. Oh, they're going to review it.
And the Eagles make some inroads here on that deficit.
Wentz's pass complete to DeSean.
Okay, so it's confirmed. Touchdown. They went right down the field. Okay. We went for 2, apparently didn't get it. I assume.
Wentz gonna throw. This one complete to Sproles. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. It's a gain
this
of 6 on the
play. Has been rough.
And make it 2nd down. Now 2nd and 4 from the 31. This will be
that didn't look like it was anyone in particular.
Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a second.
Trip, so
good about what's going on. They just played better than that.
First down. I'm getting yards here, but it's not the yards I want.
Let's go. Do it.
I have 100 yards receiving. Okay. I mean, good. That's good, right? I'm the only one getting open, really. I mean, oh, down he goes. Just don't get hurt, Wentz. Let's get out of here without him getting hurt.
Just
gonna run this clock out of run us now. Oh, and a flag. 15.
Defense. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter if you're standing.
Just because. I'll stay in a block.
Now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake.
You gotta look at the Ertz injury when this is all said and done. Okay. Not how we wanted this to go, to say the least.
And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home.
All right, so let's. We're gonna have to regroup. Not the best way to end an episode, but hey, happens in the NFL.
Sometimes it's just sharpening your execution.
So now we have to. We should get some guys back. I want to see how bad the Zach Ertz injury is, because that's huge. And then we should be getting Alshon Jeffrey back, so that should help in next episode. But let's take a look. not the most flattering picture of old Phil Rivers there. From one Phil to another, like, it just wasn't a good look.
How many of y'all came to win?
Oh, they asking my name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you. Okay, so now we're 5-2 with Dallas. We're tied at the top of the division. At the moment, obviously, they would have the tiebreaker. Alright, so next episode we will start against the 3-3 Bills. Except we're tied atop the division, but they have the tiebreaker. Let's look at injuries. Four weeks. I could have sworn it said one more week for him. Okay, do about the rest of these. Well, this, can I put people on? No, I don't get to do any of that. Alright. I could have sworn that graphic. That graphic said that he was going to be out for one more week.
This is your development trick. Superstar and superstar.
Okay. And he's out for 4 weeks. So we're going to have to do what we can here in these next couple games. Yeah, the next chunk of... Alright, so in 4 weeks, we have Bills, Bears. Not too worried about that. And then a bye week, which is very helpful at the point at this point. And it looks like we have the Patriots and Seahawks. So luckily we have some softer games and a bye, and give these times guys to give the guys time to get healthy. So we're gonna have our work cut out for us for next couple weeks battling this injury. See what Darren Sproles and the boys can do. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. I am Phil from Phil Talk Sports, and I'll catch you next time.